What is IP version 6? IP means Internet Protocol. So there are two types of version of IP. The first one is IP version 4, the second one is IP version 6. So how many bits in IP version 4 and how many bits in IP version 6? So there are 32 bit in IP version 4 and it has 128 bit address. So how many bits in IP version 6? It's a 128 bit address. So it is used just as a replacement of IP version 4. So it's a network protocol that used to assign the IP. So we can also use IP version 4 at the same time, and we can also use IP version 6 at the same time. So this process is called dual stack model. It means if we are using IP version 4 also, and we are using IP version 6 also at the same time. So Red Hat support this particular model, can also operate in a dual stack mode by default. So there is no need to do any configuration regarding if we are using IP version 4 and IP version 6 at the same time. So there is no need to do any types of configuration. By default, it's supported in a dual stack mode. It means we can also use IP version 6 at the same time. We can also use IP version 6 also. Yes. So we can use these IPs parallelly. It means we can also use IP version 4. Suppose if other client is only working with IP version 6, we can also communicate with IP version 6. And if any client only uses IP version 4, so we can also communicate with IP version 4. So at the same time, we can communicate. So what is the process to assign the IP address? That is IP version 6. So IP version 6 is a 128 bit address. So how many bit in this and how many octet in this, how to differentiate this? So in this we will discuss. So this is a 8 colon. It means it has 8 block. The first block, second block, third block, fourth block. So it has 8 block. This is your first block. This is your second block, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth. In IP version 4, how many blocks? Only 4 block. And in this, it has 8 colon separated group. It is denoted as a hexadecimal number. IP version 4 written in decimal format, while IP version 6 written in hexadecimal format. So this is a hexadecimal. It means it's 0, it's B. So B indicate alphabet. So we can use in a hexadecimal format. What is the means of nibble? Nibble means a group of 4 bit. Group of 4 bit. So it's called a nibble. It means a single digit has a value of 1 nibble. It means half byte. Half byte means how many bits in a byte? 8 bit. So in a byte, we have 8 bit. So divided this, so it's a 4. So 1 hexadecimal digit equal to 4 bit. So it will become a 4 bit, this one. So it is represented like this. So we can say that, suppose if we using IP version 4, how many bits? It's a 32 bit. If we are using a IP version 6, how many digits? It's a 128 bit. So we can differentiate this. So in IP version 4, how many block? So there are 4 block. It means 4 octet. So we can say that it's octet. But in this we can't say this octet because octet has only 8 bit. But in this we have 16 bit. So it has 8 block. Just double. So it's a IP version 6. It's a 4 time faster. It's a 4 time faster. It means it only has 32 bit address. It has 128 bit address. It has 4 block. It has 8 block. So in a one block, how many bits it can contain? It can contain only 8 bit in one block, but IP version 6, it can contain 16 bit in a one block. It means 4, again 4, again 4, again 4. So this will become 16. So in a one block, how many bits we can have? So we can use 16 bit in a one block, but in a IP version 4, we can use only 8 bit. So 32 bit, 4 block, it means 4 part, it has 8 part. In one part, how many bits? We have 8 bit. So this 8 bit is separated by dot only. This only separated by dot. It means dot symbol. It means decimal symbol. But in this IP version 6, it is separated by colon. Colon means this one. So it's separated by colon. So this is written in decimal format and this is written in hexadecimal format, hexadecimal format, this one. So this is small differentiation. So this is like that. So each nibble represents 4 bit. It means this one is a one nibble of IP version 6. So each group represents 16 bit. So how many bits in a one block? It is 16 bit. So this is a small differentiation. This is used in this all concept. This one. So I will clear this all is there. How to write this particular address? This address is write like this. So we can use, this is the writing format of this. While we are using IP version 6, so how we can write this 192.168 like this, 1.10. So, and we can use the CIDR value. It can be 24, this one. So this is the writing format of IP version 6 and sorry, IP version 4, and this is the writing format of IP version 6. But in IP version 6, we have a lot of advantage to write this. We can write this one and we can also remove this one part. This is the leading zero. It means we can remove the zero also. So we can remove only DB8. We can remove this one whole. We can only write this only zero. This one just like 10. This one only zero we can write this. This one we can only zero use. Only zero we can use. And here we can only one. And this is separated by colon. Separated by colon. Only colon. This also the colon. So this is the writing format. So how to write this and how to small this? So this will say to make IP version 6 addresses easier to write. How to write this? The leading zero in the colon separated group do not need to write. So there is no need to write the whole part. We can also use this part. We can also use only zero. We can also use only zero, only zero. So we can remove the leading zero. It means there is no need to write this. So at least one hexadecimal digit must be written in colon separated group. So this is the format, another format. We can also use like this format to write IP version 6. We can also use this one. So 200 1 DB8 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. So this is a format. And we can also small this one also. How to small this? Since addresses with long string, suppose we have a zero here, 10, second number also zero, third number also zero. So in the place of leading zero, again zero, again zero, again zero. Continuous, we have zero. So we can also use colon and again colon in the part of this one. So we can also use to sort this by using the double colon. Double colon means in the between these columns it has continuous zero. So what is the process of this? One or more consecutive, it means continuous, of zero only may be combined by using which particular format? Double colon. It means like this. So it is also, we can also use this smallest part. Suppose we want to communicate between two pieces, so we can also use a address 200. We can use small part like 64. So one IP sign this 2, 3, 4. So we can sort this particular format. So it has a lot of advantages also. So this can be used, but we can't sort IP version 4. So IP version 4 has some limitation, and IP version 6 has some advantages also to write. How to write this? So I will show the next one part. So this is the writing format. Then again, another less convenient. So this is the same. All are the same. I will move to the next one. This one, suppose if we are using anyone can tell me what is the meaning of this? We have IP 192.168. We have IP 10.10, and we use colon just colon and 80. What is the meaning of this one?
It's just a connection for an HTTP.
So this is my IP, and what is this? This is my
port number. 80 is
port number. This is my port number. So this will become as a socket. Suppose if we are using a web server in my company, and we want to use this one as a suppose 8081. So we can also use, suppose for the port forwarding, any request come this will forward to this one also. So in a port forwarding, and we can also change this for the security reason. So we can change here. So this will become a socket. So like suppose if we are using IP version 6 and we want to access my port also by using the IP address. So how to write this in a web server part, in a other part, for any concepts while including TCP and UDP network ports after the IP version 6, always enclose the IP version 6 in this particular part. So this will enclose through the square bracket. And after that, you can write the port number. So this is the format to write IP plus port format in IP version 6 part. If any need to write this when we are using a web server, we can also use the subnetting for the IP version 6, but there is no need to do this because mostly this part is a network part and this part is a host part, all host part. And we can use number of PC, how many PC we can connect. It's a 2^64 plus we can also do the subnetting in a 16 to 16. It means we can also use for the which part? For to assign the IP address. It means 64 plus this part. So we can use lot of IP address without any subnetting. This is without any subnetting. We can also this part for the network portion, reserved for the network portion. But we can also do the subnetting in this part also, this one. So this part is reserved, and this part, this 16, it means 65536. So this will become this one. So how many addresses for the host? This one. So these parts for the network portion also. This part for the host portion. So this all for the host, and we can also use this 16 for the host also. So we can use this. So I will show the differences. Normal IP version 6. So we have the IP address. The first one is unicast IP. The second one is a multicast IP. The third one is a broadcast IP. So there is no broadcast address in IP version 6. We can only use unicast IP. We can also use multicast IP. We have a new concept that is called anycast IP. So there are three types of IPs in this: unicast IP, multicast IP, anycast. Anycast means we can assign one IP to two devices. We can use one IP on two devices. There is no conflict, but we should assign this as a anycast. It means, suppose this is your router and this is your router and this is a client. So this will select the nearest one. Suppose for this particular client, this particular router is the nearest. So it is also the same IP. This is also the same IP. So we can use the anycast IP in IP version 6, but there is no broadcast in IP version 6. So this is the unicast address divided into two parts. So any IP address, it can be IP version 4, it can be IP version 6. There are two type parts. The first part is the network part. The second part is the host part. This whole part is reserved for the network. But if we want to do the subnetting, so we can use this 16 bit to define the subnets. It means we can create the network portion. This whole part for the host. And the interface ID. In this IP version 6, this host is called interface ID. Network portion identify the subnet part. It means network part. To know two network interfaces on the same subnet have the same interface ID. Interface ID means same IP. The interface ID define a particular interface on a subnet. It means if we have a NIC, so we should assign one IP here also. We have another IP, another IP. Another NIC has another IP address. So every particular NIC has an individual IP address. So this is reserved part, and we can also use this part to define the subnets, this one. So this is the process if we want to use the subnetting in a IP version 6, but mostly we don't do this particular concept because we have a lot of IP addresses. So there is no concept like A class, B class, C class in IP version 6. So there is no concept the classes, but some addresses are reserved for specific purposes. Like suppose if we are using a localhost IP, so this is also reserved. If we are using the unspecified address, this is also reserved. Global address, this is the reserved IP. So these are the specific addresses that are used for the specific purpose. So in this, there is no concept regarding A class. Suppose this is my A class, B class, C class, D class. So there is no range in this. So this is A class, this is B class, this is C class. In this, we can use all the addresses, but some addresses are reserved, these one. For a specific purpose, we can use this. So this one. So this is the localhost. It means this is the loopback address, IP. What is the IP of loopback? :\1, this one, /128. It means only one IP is reserved for this. but in a IP version 6, sorry, IP version 4, so it is 8. This is 127.0.0.1. This is the global localhost, but we can also use the other addresses also. It means 1677216. These addresses used for the localhost 16777, 3 times 7, 216. What do you want to ask, Siddhant? /24. Where is /24?
It will be at the end.
Which 24? Which for the IP version 4?
If we borrow any one number, it will become a 25. If he doesn't borrow anything, it will be a 24, right?
Yes, okay. I will show you. For IP version 4 or IP version 6, it means when we want to do subnetting, so we should borrow some part from the host in defining the subnetting. It can be also IP version 4, same process for the IP version 6. The process will be same when we do subnetting. Suppose this is my IP version 4 part, so it is 32 bits, whole part is 32 bit. And if we are using A class, so how many parts for the network? 8. So you are asking, that is 24. 24 means all part for the host. It means by default. If we do a subnetting in this, so we can borrow from the host part. Mostly to do the subnetting, we borrow some bits for the network. Suppose in this, how many networks we can define? We can define 126 network. If we are using the A class, only A class we can define 126 network. If we are using more than 126, so what we will do? So we should borrow the bits from the host portion. If we borrow 2 bits, like example, so it's 2 key, 2 power of 2. It means we can create 4 network. So this will become 126 plus 4. It means we can create 130 network. This one is the separate. So this is from the host portion. So we can borrow in IP version 4 also and IP version 6 also. But in IP version 6, there is a method to do the subnetting. So that is the this method. We can't do change this, but if we want to change this sum, so we can use 16 bit. We can reserve the 16 bit to create the subnets. So how many subnets? It means how many subnets we can define in this. So this is a one part only. This one part can be separated as a 2 power of 16. If we want to use, if we not use, then we can define this. We can also use this host part to create the subnet also, this one also, but there is no need to do this. If we want to use, we can also use. Suppose we are using a number that is 20201. This is my number, then colon. We want to use only one IP, so what I will do, we using one. Then we can also use 128 here. We can also use 126 here. It means we use this particular host part to define the subnet also, because we want to reserve the host part. We only use two host, we can only use 20 host, we can only use. So according to the host, according to the network requirements, we can do subnetting this in IP version 4 also and IP version 6 also. Then what is the meaning of these particular IP address? Suppose these are the specific IP address. This is reserved for the local host. It means it is equivalent to local host, that is regarding to the IP version 4. So this whole part can be reserved for the local host, but this is the global IP for the local host that is mostly used, 127.0.0.1. And I will show one example of this, not only the theoretical portion, this one. If we use I am doing a ping to local host, so this is ping to my local host. So what is the local host IP? This one. In Windows by default this is the preferred one. If we are using IP version 4 and IP version 6, so IP version 6 is the first preference. And if I want to use the IP version 4, so what I will do, then give one option, that is 4. So this will show me the IP version 4 IP of local host. So this is the global IP for the local host, or we can say that loopback. This is also known as loopback address, loop back address, this one. So this is called loopback, and this is also called the localhost IP. To check the connectivity to its own NIC, it means there is a no transmission outside from your network. It means outside from your NIC. So it's called loopback. It means this is my area. If we want to communicate within this, so we can't send any packet outside from the network. So we send the network that is come back, then come back, only this particular area, not outside. So it's also called the loopback address. So there is no traffic can be sent outside from the network if we are using this particular address. Suppose we have a web server and we want to check this server is opened or not. So we can also use this particular address. So for different applications, we can use the loopback addresses to check that is active or not. Suppose we are using IP version 4, it's not this one, only use 6 here, 6. So this is for the IP version 6. If we use here loopback, it's also ping. Loop loopback, also ping. By default, this check the connectivity to its own PC. Own PC means there is a no connectivity outside from the network, only this particular system, then back. This particular system, then back. So it's called loopback. So this is the IP version 6 loopback addresses. So this is about the IP version 4 and IP version 6 loopback addresses. Suppose this is the address that is unspecified. Unspecified means if we have two NIC card, this one and this one, this has a different IP, this has a different IP. So if we want to send the request, so that will goes to this one also, this one also. So this is the IP address that is not specified, this one. So this is called unspecified address. It means we can send the request to any IP address. It can be this, it can be this, to send the traffic to any NIC card that is regarding to your system. And the third one is that is colon colon 0, it means this is a default root. So default root is this IP is mostly used when we communicate. This is my PC and I have a connection through the ISP and we want to open any address. It can be Facebook, it can be Google. So we send the request to my router. So this is my router. So every particular router has configured a default root. Default root means we want to send the traffic to, it can be Google, it can be Facebook, it can be any, not specified. So we can use the default root to send the traffic to the outside the network. So we use a default root in the router that is configured by the ISP. So this is used in a router. I will show this. So I type one command, that is root print, this one. So I will show the all routing table. In this we have also the default root. So this is the default root that is configured by the ISP on my router. So this is the gateway address of my router and this is the root that is configured in my router. So this is the IP that is called default root IP. And this is my own interface IP, that is 192.168.1.13. And this is the gateway address. It means my router IP. And this is the root. This is the default root address. So this root is configured by the ISP. So these are all the routing table information. So what is the use of this one? So this is also equivalent, this one. If we are using the IP version 6, so this is IP version 6 IP, this like this. If we are using root print. So these all IPs regarding to the IP version 6, this is the IP version 6 table, this one. In this part, for the loopback, this part link local. So these all IPs regarding the link local address, this is also link FE80, that is starting from the FE80, all addresses are the link local. This is the this one multicast. What is this particular IP? This particular IP is multicast address and this particular IP is link local address. So we can check. It can be your Windows machine, it can be your Linux machine, all process will be same. I will show this. So these are the specific addresses that are reserved in my system. So these all addresses, it has some metric value also, network part also, description and gateway. This is my own link, it means it's my own network interface card. It's known as NIC. NIC means network interface card. So these addresses are reserved for the specific purpose. So this is reserved for the localhost. This is unspecified. This is the default root. And this address is reserved for the global. So we can also use the global IP address. So these all addresses, this is the range. From this particular range to this particular range, we can use the global IP addresses. So this has the specific range 2000 and the last one is, so we can use 2002 300, but in IP version 6 we use the hexadecimal value. So this finish from F, also F, again F. So this is the starting and this is the 3FFF. So this one is the last address and /16 means we can use this part for the network and the whole portion for the IPs, it means host. So this is the big range. and these are also reserved. This is the local link. Link, it means local IPs. It not directly equivalent to the private, but it is, it can be locally used. That start from FD 00/16. So these can be used in a local network. So these are not reserved. It means we can do, we can't use this IP in a public network. So these are for the local connectivity. Just like in a A class, we have the range for 10. In a B class, we have a range for 172. In a C class, we have a range in a 16. So these are the local IPs. Just like same way, this IP is reserved for the local uses. And this IP is reserved for the link local. It means for the local connectivity. And this is for the multicast. So there is no broadcast here. So in IP version 6, we can't use broadcast address. So this is the small introduction about the specific IP address. So this is localhost. This is unspecified. So you should know about this. Not in a deep, but you should know what is ::1, what is ::, what is ::0, what is 200/3, what is FD00/. So this is a link, local addresses, this is a local host IP, this is a multicast IP, this is a global IP, this is a default route, this is unspecified, this one. So this is the description, you can read this. So you can understand this better. If any doubt regarding the specific IP addresses, you can ask. So these are all the addresses that we can use. Then I will, so what is the process to give the IP address? It means what is the configuration, how to assign the IP version 6 in my PC. So there are three processes to assign the IP. The first one is static, second one is dynamic. So we have the third process in IP version 6. So that is called, which one? That is known as the automatic, but there is another name of this. So that is, manual, automatic, dynamic, and network using the DHCP. This one, that is also called the SLAC. This process provide the IP address the automatically. If we are suppose the first part is static, the second part is dynamic. So what is the process of the dynamic? If we have the DHCP server in my network, dynamic host configuration protocol, sorry, P. If we have the DHCP process, then we can assign the process using the dynamic. This is for the static. Static means manually, dynamically. The first process is SLAC. It means in this process, if there is no DHCP working in my network, then this particular process will provide the IP address. It's called stateless address auto configuration. So it's known as, also known as the automatic IP. There is no static, there is no dynamic, then this process will work and you can find the IP address from which particular range? This particular range. FE80, this one. So not this. So this process is used in IP version 6. So there are different theory regarding to assign the IP version 6. So read this whole thing, you can use. So there are two way which address get to configure network interface. So we have the network address, host address. So we can use, if we are, there is a network administrator. So you can use static. If there is a DSCP, you can use dynamic by using the DSCP server. So mostly we use static and dynamic. These two processes mostly used. It can be your IP version 4 and it can be your IP version 6. For the both process, we mostly use static IP and we use the dynamic IP. And the third process, that is called automatic. In IP version 4, there is a process called APIPA. APIPA. This process will provide the IP, APIPA, automatic private IP address. From which particular range? This particular 169.254.0, then again 0, again 0. So this is the range, but it is only used in a Microsoft machine, not for the other. So this is specific. Like this particular same way, we can use Slack or DSCP version 6. That is process. So these are process to assign the IP. Manual, two method for the dynamic. This one and the another one. So these all, so there is a any IP address that is called anycast. Anycast means we can assign a single IP to two machine, it can be three machine, it can be four machine. So the nearest one is selected for the IP address. Slack is also for Microsoft. It can be used other also. Slack is only used in IP version 6 only, not for. In IP version 4, it's called APIPA. Okay, Rahul?
Sir, I want to know that, like APIPA is used in Windows or Microsoft in IP version 4.
Yes, yes.
Is Slack is also you work as same like for Windows only and Microsoft also only?
We can also use Slack for the IP version 4. But there is a different process to use this.
Okay.
But mostly we use this IP version 6. Because Slack means in a Slack, MAC address is used. So how many bits in a MAC address? 48. How many bits in a IP version 430? So this process cannot be used because it's a 32-bit address. So this process, it can be used only the this one. Because this IP, this 48-bit address will be added in your IP version 6. So this cannot be used in IP version 4. I will show this. This is all about the multicast. Read this whole thing, then any doubt, then we can clear this one. This is started only the FE80 address, Slack address. Okay. So read this all process, then I will discuss because it has a lot of theory. Then I will start from this one. So from this, the practical part is started. Because we have more and more practical parts in this session. So your theoretical portion, what we have discussed? We have discussed about the IP version 4, what is the IP version 4 and what is the IP version 6. But we should more know the small things. How many bits in this? That is 32 bit. How many bits in this? It's a 128 bit. So we should know about this and this. If we have the knowledge how to assign this and how to assign this. So we can assign these IP addresses on my machine. So this is my main motive. And you should read about this the theoretical portion, it has the more theoretical portion, it also have the more portion that is covered in CCNA portion, because there is a different for this, there is a different chapter for this, not only one, more and more chapters regarding this. So this is covered in a networking portion, but in this we should know what is IP version 4 and what is IP version 4. So we discuss about the theoretical portion also, so we can understand how many bits in IP version 4 and how to assign this, what is A class, what is B class, C class in IP version 6, how to sort this. So we should know about this. So I will clear all of these things. Then if we want to assign the host name and also assign the IP address, so what I will do, so this is the practical part that I will discuss with you. So I will discuss host name also, and after then the validation also, then how to display the IP address, display the static information, connectivity, how to check the connectivity, how to trace the routing information, routing table information, these all things I will discuss. So these are the SS process, net state process, whole things I will discuss. So first I will start from the IP. So we have two machine, this is my one machine and this is my second machine. So I will start this one first. When you install your OS, there is no IP address in the machine, but I will check what is the IP of my machine. So to check the IP address, what is the command? IP ADDR, this is the command to check the IP address. So what is the IP address of your machine? You can check by IP config command, you can check this by the IP ADDR command. So this is the IP ADDR command. So this will show what is the IP of my machine. This is the IP address of my machine. This is the broadcast address of my machine. So what is the MAC address of my machine? This is the MAC address. This is the broadcast address. So I will tell you IP also. I will tell you the MAC on. MAC address also. So how many bits in IP version 4? 30. How many bits in MAC? 48. So Vijay, can you tell me how many hexadecimal digit in a MAC address? Vijay, hexadecimal digit.
40. It has six columns Within that, we have a two. So we have mentioned 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
And how many bytes?
16.
16. How many bytes in a MAC address? So there are three things. This is regarding to bit. How many bits? 48. How many hexadecimal digits? That is 12, not 16. That is 12. How many hexadecimal digits? You can count here. So I will tell you. So this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is 7, 8, 9, 10, this is 11, this is 12. So how many hexadecimal digits? It's a 12-bit hexadecimal digit address. Because you know that one hexadecimal digit equal to 4 bit. So multiply this, this will become this one. So anyone can ask how many bytes. So this is a 6-byte address. In a 1-byte, how many digits? 8. So multiply this one, this will become 48-bit address. So what is MAC address? This is my link, or it's called Ethernet address, it's called physical address, it's called MAC address. So how many digits in a MAC address? So this is 12. How many bytes? This is 1 byte, 2 byte, 3 byte, 4 byte, 5, 6. So how many bytes? 6. How many hexadecimal digits? 12. How many bits? So these three concepts you should know about the MAC address. Because we should know minimum layer 2 information, we should know minimum layer 3 information and layer 4 also. Suppose if we want to go in a layer 4, so we should know about the port address. Suppose this is the port for the HTTP, this is the port for the HTTPS, this is the port for 21 for the FTP, 20 and 21, 22 for the SSS. So these three information should be required to do any types of activity. So this is regarding the layer 2 information. In a layer 2 switch work, in a layer 3 router work, in layer 4 no devices can work. But some firewalls work on application layer also, session layer also. So it is regarding Pyare, Dost, Naresh, Teri, Sadi, Par, Aunga. So this is regarding this. Physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport, session, presentation, application. So these all upper concept, but we should know minimum these four concept. So this is transport layer regarding to this one. This is the this verb. So this is the IP to transport. What is the IP? Network layer. So this is regarding to layer 3. Data link layer, this is regarding to MAC address. What is the physical address? It means your that device name is, it can be hub, or it can be your wire also, and it can be your connector also. These all the physical devices work on the physical layer. So you should minimum 3 and 4 information for whole things. So this is my NIC. So what is the nickname of my? So this is my LAN card. So we have broadcast address, we have multicast address. So this is the MTU of this particular, and this is the IP address of this. What is this? Give me 1 minute. What happened in my screen? So my screen is visible or not? Now check.
Yes, yes.
Okay. So what I am discussing, so this is your nickname, this is your MAC address, this is your IP address, and this is your link local address. Regarding that is IP version 6. This is your broadcast address, and this is your layer 2 broadcast address. So देखिए, so if we start any IP, the first IP is that is called network address. The last IP is broadcast address. Between this and this, we use the valid addresses. But in a MAC address, we also have the unique multicast address. We also have the broadcast address. So what is the broadcast address? This one. If anyone asks you what is the layer 2 broadcast address, so layer 2 broadcast address is FF, again FF, again FF, then again FF, again FF. So this is 12 digit. So this is regarding the broadcast address of layer 2. If you have IP version 4, so what is the broadcast address of you? In every subnet, there is one broadcast address. So the broadcast address, the first address is network. So the last one is the broadcast. So network address start from the 0. This is always 0. This is always 255. Between this 1 and 254. So these are the valid addresses. So we can use. So what is my IP address? This is my IP address. This is regarding to the valid address. So valid address only assigned to my NIC. It means LAN card. Like if we are using the IP like this, I will show one small example only for the demonstration. This one. Suppose if we start any IP, suppose we use here 0. Can we assign 0 in a starting bit or not? Can we use 0 as IP? No, right. Because this is unspecified address. So this will change this. Suppose we use here 0. It will automatically change to 1. 0 is automatically changed to 1. See here, 0 is not a valid entry. So please specify the value. So in IP version 4, we can only use from this one part to this one part. It means A class to C class, because A start to 1 that end with 126, B class end start to 128, end with 191, this is start 192, 223. So this is 223 is the last, that is start from 1 to 223. It means we can only use A class, B class and C class. So we can't use D class IP in my machine. Cannot use also the D and E. These two class cannot be used in the PC. It means in my machine. So we can only use from 1 to 223. So this is the valid entry that can be assigned on my machine. So we can use 0 here also. Again 0 here also. But we can't use 0 on the last bit also, because I will tell you what is the use of this. This is called your network address. So this one is the network address to assign. If we use just click here. So this is my subnet mask. So IP and subnet mask, this is the combination. Without this combination, we can't use the IP. When we click on OK, so this will show me if we use GR on the zero, sorry, on the last portion, it means host portion, all will be zero. So this is called the network address. So this will show me the combination of IP and subnet mask we use is invalid, because in the last portion, this one, if we use all bits as a zero, so this will become as a network address. Host portion, this is the host portion, because this is reserved 8 bit for the network, these all 24 for the host. So we have all bits zero in a host portion. So this called host portion, this one, host address portion of the IP addresses are set to zero, because at this time we have all the zeros. We have all the zero, this will become a network portion. It means network address. So please give the valid entry. It means valid combination of IP address with subnet mask. So we use from 1 to the last one is 254. This one, this one. So from this to this, we can use in a 1 octet. So this is the small information regarding the IP address. So if we assign here 1, so we can use, you can see, we can assign this. So which IP address can be assigned on my machine? It is start through from 1 and end through 254. And suppose if we are using 255, can we assign this? If we use here 255, can we assign this? Siddhant, your answer is no. And anyone can
broadcast? No, no, we can't assign.
So B class begin from 218. Not 218. B class, I will tell you the class of A, that is 0 to 127. Okay, that start from 1 and end from 128. Not, sorry, 126. The address for the B class, that is start from 128. Not 218. Siddhant, for you. And this is end with 191. So this is the valid range.
By mistake, I typed 218.
Okay, okay, okay. Okay, so I will tell you. Okay. So your, so can you tell me, I can use this one as a last or not? Tell me. Anyone, if have the knowledge regarding this, can tell me.
It's in a broadcast, so I guess we won't use 255.
But check here, this is a A class. In A class, how many bits for the network? So this is the network portion, we can't change one.
Oh, okay.
But in this, we have how many bits? These 24, it means this whole portion, this whole portion, and this also whole portion reserved for the host. So we can use these all portion for the host. So how many IP we can use here? 1677716. It means 1 crore. It means 1666167772 16. So these are the whole portion for the IP. So we can assign in A class, B class, but we can't assign this in a C class, because C class has 24 for the network and 8 bit for the host. So it cannot be assigned in C class, but we can use this A class also, B class also, C here. This can also be used. If we use whole portion for this. This can also be used in A class, but this can't be used in B class, because B class only have the 16 bit for the host and 16 bit for the subnet. But it can be used in a B A class. You can see here. So you can also assign this. Suppose if we use all bits, but it can't be used because this will become the broadcast address, as you tell me. So not this is as a broadcast. This is as a broadcast. When we use 255 in three portion, this is your host portion. This is your host portion. In host portion, we use 255 here and 255 here. Then this will become a broadcast address. So you can't use this because broadcast address is a reserved address. It only be used for the broadcasting purpose, not for to assigning on a PC. See here, what it will display me. Please read this. This will give you a information. So what is the reason behind this? So it can't be used. See, this is my host portion. This is my host portion. In this portion, we have set all the bits 1. So in electronics, as you know, we count all the bits as a 0. If we have all bits as a 0, this is 4, this is 4. So this is called one block. This is your one block. So we can't use all bits as a 0 because these will become as a network addresses. If we use all the bits as a 1, these whole, so this will become your broadcast address. So these two addresses cannot be used in my machine because these are for the specific purpose. Suppose if we send the message to my whole devices, so which address can be used? This one. If we denote, this is my lab 1, this is my lab 2, so which address is used for the lab 1? This address. Which is used for the reserve for the lab 2? This address. It means if we are using 192.168.1.0, so this is my network address. In lab 2, 2.0, so this first address is used for lab 2 network address, but this is an address that is not regarding to the A class, B class and C class. So this can't be used. So this is called unspecified address. This is a global. When we have 255 also, 255 also here, 255 here, 255. So this is called global broadcast address also. So you should know the small information about the IP address, which address can be used, which address cannot be used. So these are the concepts that you should know about the IP address. So this is my Microsoft TCP IP. And at this time we using the invalid address. So this will show me the information. So my OS, it can be Linux OS, it can be a other OS. It have the information which is network address, which is broadcast address. So it can't use this portion. When we use the last one as a 254, so this is a valid address because at this time all bits not be 0. So it can be used, this one. So in A class, how many bits for the network? 8 bit. And how many bits for the host? 24. If all the 24s will become as 1, so it can't be used. But if we are using a B class, that is start from 128.0.0.0. So this 0, that is a network address. So this can't be used. So how we can understand? So this is all bits 1, this is all bits. It means 16 bit for the network and these 16 bit for the host. So we can only use how many addresses? That is 65536. These addresses can be used in a B class. So this is my, according to B class, this is my network address. So we can't use in a network address, whole bits will be zero. So all bits will be zero, it can't be used. So this is my network address for this particular subnet. If we use one here, so it can be used. We see here, if we use 255, we can also use this also in a B class. If we use all the bits, this portion, this will be full. If this will be full, it can't be used. So this will be full. So these all 16 bit will become one. So it can't be used because this is a broadcast address. 255 here, 255 here will become broadcast. See here, set to one. It means in a host portion. So like this. So you should know this. If we use 254 here, so this will be a valid address. So valid address can be assigned in A class, in B class, in C class also. Okay. Then in what is the concept regarding the C class? See, C class start from 192.0.0.0. So these all the zero. It can be anything. It can be also anything. So there is no concept behind this. We use only first concept that indicate it is a A class, B class and C class. And this is the last concept. This belong to, this is a network address, this is a valid address and this is a broadcast address. So this relate. So from this we start the class and this is for the valid address, network address and broadcast address information. So this can't be used. So in C class, how many bits for the network? 6, 8, 8 and again 8. It means 24 for the network and only 8 bit for the host. It means we can only assign 254 IPs, not more than 22. So it start from 1. We can use, if we use this as a 254, this is the last we can use also. If we use 255, it can't be used because we only have the 8 bit for the host portion, this one. It can be 255, it can be this. There is no concept. What is here? So this, it all bit 1, 1. So it can't be used. So this is a concept, which address can be assigned and which address cannot be assigned. And what is the reason behind this? It means if we have A class, we can use 8 bit. If we have B class, we can use 16 bit for the network. And if we have C class, we can use 24 bit for the network creation and 8 bit for the host creation IPs. So this is the concept. So any doubt? So I will prove this as a practically also. That is, I discuss as a theoretically also. So any discussion, any doubt, and any question from your side, you can ask. So I am telling about this one. So we start my concept. Okay. So I will perform a practical. Suppose if we have a machine, and we want to assign the IP. So what is the command to assign the IP? Anyone can tell me what is the command to assign the IP in Linux machine, any Linux machine? What is the command to give the IP? Anyone know the command name? Which command you use to assign the IP? Okay. And any other candidate know the command? Okay, I will tell you. So we have two processes to assign the IP. The first process is GUI and the second process is CUI. GUI means which command we can use? NM. NM stands for Network Manager. TUI, Terminal User Interface. And which command for the CUI? That I will use NM CLI. So this is the command to assign the IP address on any Linux operating system that is regarding RHEL 7, RHEL 8, because these cannot be work on RHEL 7, because in RHEL 7 we have a different command, that is setup command, that is used in RHEL 6. So we can use this. So I will start. So in my machine, we provide the IP. So that is 192.168.100.100/24. It means this particular IP I will assign. I will assign the subnet mask also here. So which subnet mask? 255.255.255.0, this subnet mask. And this can also be used like this, /24. Okay, then we provide the gateway IP. So what is the gateway IP? That is 192.168.100.1. This is my gateway IP. So we assign these two IPs, IP address, subnet mask, and gateway. Then I will use DNS. So DNS IP can be 8.8.8.8. It can be 202.56.215.54. It can be anything. Any DNS address that is used in your network, you can use. But this is a Google IP and this is a Airtel. Airtel. So I will start. If any doubt, because this is a big command, but I will show you small things, so you can't do to remember all the things. So this, it's a big command, we can't recognize this, we can't remember this, so there is no things to remember. You should know the concepts. So what is the command? NM CLI, this is the command, and we type just enter. So this will show me the some information regarding to my the NIC. So we have only one network interface card that is assigned to my VMware machine. So this is my VM machine, and this is my Ethernet address. So this is my MAC address. So MAC address is also known as the hardware address. This is the MPU of this. And at this time we have one IP address also. And this is the root address. Root address, it means this is my network part. So it means this is my network address. So this is used for the routing purpose, because in a routing, the first IP address is used. So this is the root. It means for the routing purpose, this IP is used. If you have the information about the router, in a router to assign the network, which IP address is used? This IP. So this is my root 4 address. and this is the root. This is the INET 6. INET 6 means for the. So this is your link local address, and this is your root 6. So these two addresses reserved. So this is my bridge address. This is my loopback address. Loopback address is also known as a localhost. This one. This is your bridge, NIC. So this will show me information. If you want to do to show any information regarding the IP, you can use this particular information, NMCLI device info. So this will show, and you can also go to the manual page of this, so you can get the lot of information. So these are the manual pages, but I will show. Press 2 times tab, this one. So this will show me the information. Connection between virtual and real machine bridge. Yes. For this, so bridge we can be use bridge address. So these are the commands. If we want to create the connection, in these connections also known as the profile. Suppose we want to create a profile, or we want to create the connection. So this command we can use. But first we should know. How many devices, how many NIC we have in my machine. So we should use this particular command, device status. So this command provide me the information regarding the NIC. So what type information this will show me? NIC means network interface card information. So how many NIC we have in my machine? So we have only one NIC in my machine. How can we differentiate this? We have this also, but this is your NIC, because here you can see type means we using the Ethernet network. So this is your Ethernet, and this is your network interface card that is connected to your machine. This is your connection name. This is your bridge. This is your loopback, and this is your tunnel information. So these are the other information, and this is my one network interface card. And we want to create a connection, a new connection. So which command we can use? This one. So use here NMCLI, type only C, then tab. All the command automatically. So this also support the auto tab completion format, and type here just information. So this will give the information about the connections. So these are the connection that is in your system, and we want to create a new connection, then type 2 times tab again. So these are the commands. So we should create a connection at this time. So we use this command. If we want to delete the connection, we can use this command. If we want to up and down my connection, we can use this particular command for down, this particular command for up. Show the information, reload the information, modify the information. We have lot of commands. But at this time, we use only this one. So we use this one. So this is the command. This is my first argument. This is my second argument. Then type just enter. So this will show me. You should type the third argument also. So this is my third argument. Because without the type, we can't create the connection. So you should specify here Ethernet also. So type is the third command, third argument. It means next command, type. What type you are using? Ethernet. Then again enter. It will show me this is not a complete command. You should know in if means interface name. So what is your interface name? This one. So you should also this one. This is your interface name. Type this one also. How you can define what is my interface name? Then type 2 times tab. So not this. Interface if name. Then 2 types. So this is my interface name. This one. So type this one. Then type enter. See here, your connection will be created. But here, this will take the name automatically from this and this one from this. So this will automatically take these combine these two names automatically. If you want to assign the name, so you can use again command. Which command we can use? We have lot of commands, 2 to 1, but we can't show this. Then type here con, then again tab. So these are the commands, con hyphen, then name. See, 2 times tab. So you should give the name here. Suppose we want to create a connection. My connection name is my new con 1. Then at this time it will take according to your own choice. So we have 2 commands. The first one is this command, the second one is this command. So this is the process to create. So this is a first practical, how to create a connection. Because if we have the connection, then we can provide the IP. So first we should have a connection. If you have connection, then you can provide the IP. So at this time we have 2 connections. How I can check this? By using connection show command. This is the command. So we have this connection also. We have this connection also. In a one network interface card, we can create multiple connections, but only one connection will be active. So any doubt how to create a connection? So these 2 commands will be used. You can also use this command and you can also use this command. It's depend on your choice. If you want to assign the name according to your choice, you can give the name. Mostly we use this command. But if you want to assign the IP at the same time, then what you will do? Suppose we give a name. So this command will be a long, will become long if you assign the IP at the same time. IP, then give V, then 2 times tab. How many commands regarding the IP? You can also use the IP address for the DNS, for the DNS gateway, for the this particular command, for the manual entry, it means static, you should assign this one also. So we have lot of commands, but we want to assign the IP. So that is IP version 4 dot addresses. Then give any IP. Suppose we assign 20 20 20 10, and we use the CIDR value. It means subnet mask. So this is my IP and this is my subnet mask value. And we use IP version 4 dot gateway. So this one is my gateway 20 20 21. This is my gateway IP. What is my DNS? So you can give DNS also at the same time. DNS also. So what is my DNS? 8.8.8.8. This one. And IP version 4.method you should assign, because at this time we are giving the manual IP, because by default it is configured as auto. So we should assign manual. And IP, not this one, that is connection auto connect, auto connect, yes. So this is the whole command, this one. So it's a big command, but we can divide this command in multiple parts. In the first part we can assign IP, in second part we can assign gateway, in third part we can assign DNS, the fourth command we can also this, fifth we can divide this all. But if we have the information, so we can assign this whole part in a one command. So it's a big and big command. But you don't remember all of these things. You should know the concept. This one you should understand. So this is command. You are creating connection add. So this is a different thing. It's your type. This is your interface name. These are mandatory, these three concepts. But these, it can be used in a one part. So this is your name and this is your IP. This is your IP address. This is your gateway address. This is the network address. This is the method manual. This is the connection automatic. In RHEL 7, that is by default no. So in RHEL 8, this is by default yes. If you don't use this command, so there is no need to write this one. If we are using 7, so this is mandatory. If you start your machine, your connection will be start automatically. You don't need to up and down again and again this particular. So your IP will work when you start your machine. But in RHEL 7, in RHEL 6, that is default, by default, this is no. When you start your machine, this connection not be start automatically. So you should start this again and again. So this particular command required for that particular reason. When we type here, just enter. See, your connection will be created and you can see your IP will be assigned or not. You can also use IP config command also. Config. So not IP config, if config. It's a if config. Because IP config work on this. So see here, at this time, this IP not assigned because at this time, this connection will work. Which particular connection? See, using this particular command. At this time, your this connection will work. But if you up your this particular connection, then your 20 range of IP address will be used. And you want to use this particular. So enable this particular profile, my con. On NM select connection. Sorry, up. Then my con. Not con. My new. Con to this one. Then this connection will be active through the network manager. Then see here again IP config. So this is your IP address. And this is your net mask. I have assigned the 255.255.255 because that is, this is your broadcast address. This is the broadcast of this particular range. Because every subnet has its own broadcast IP. This is your MAC address. So this is a small thing. But where is my gateway? Where is my DNS? And you want to see this. So you can use two. In the place of up, we use so, this one. So this will show the whole things. This is your connection name. This is your 802. This is assigned by the IEEE for the wired network. For the wireless, it is 802.11. For wired, 802.3. And for the wireless, 802.11. This is your nickname. And this is your DNS address, and this is your IP address, this is your gateway address. So you can see whole things, this all. So this is about the IP version 4. So this is your IP version, this is your gateway for the root, this is my network address. And this is no information, this has no information, this is your destination, this is your DNS, this is your link local. So these whole information will be displayed by using this particular command. So in this, what I will tell you, this is my first command, Then what I do, this is my second command and this is my third command. So any doubt, these three commands, you should write these all commands, because in a book, this whole thing you can see, but in a different way, not like this. So you should write this. Okay. So any question regarding how to create a connection and at the same time how to assign the IP, at the same time how to assign the gateway IP, DNS IP also, and give the concept, it means it's a static IP, it means manual. Suppose if we have a DHCP server in my network, suppose we want to assign the dynamic IP, DYNAMIC, that is assigned by the DHCP server in my network, then we can assign the dynamic IP. So how to provide the IP through the DHCP? In the second concept, I will discuss. So first thing, I have give the information regarding the static IP, how to provide a static IP in my machine. In a second thing, I will show how to provide a IP through the DHCP server. So if you have any doubt regarding these commands, so give me text. If no doubt, then we start this particular concept. I will take 10 to 15 minutes, then I will end the session, okay? Because your time has been completed, it's 11:54, but I will take 10 to 12 minutes more. So, any doubt? Okay. Then we will start regarding the dynamic process. Suppose if we want to assign a IP through the DHCP, so first we should create a connection. We should create a connection. So I'm creating a connection. My connection name is DYNAMIC, dynamic underscore convert. This is my dynamic connection. So in a dynamic connection, which commands will be needed? This also needed, connection also needed, add also needed, type, Ethernet, interface. So this is mandatory. If you don't provide this information, so it will take the name automatically. So these are the mandatory concepts for providing the IP through the DHCP server. So create the connection first. This is the step one process. This has been completed. And then give second command, NMCLI, connection up. Up this particular connection, so it will take the IP through the DHCP server. See here, because at this time there is no DHCP, okay, we have DHCP. If we don't have DHCP, it will take time. Not completed, it will show me the error. It means at this time we have the DHCP in my network. So it will get the IP through the DHCP server also. How I can check this? So type here, show command. You can see I'm getting the IP or not. Okay, I will get the IP because there is a router in my network that is configured, which provide me the IP, that is 192.168.1.54. This is my CIDR value. It means this is my prefix value. It means we also call this subnet value. This is my gateway. This is the gateway IP. And this is the default root configuration. So this is the default root that is configured in my router. So we can communicate outside from my local network. So this is the IP. This is my network address information. And this is the gateway information also. So at this time we are using this one. And I want to communicate through to outside from my host, then give a command ping www.facebook.com. See here. At this time, we have the reachability to the Facebook IP also. So this is the name of the Facebook, and this is the IP address of the Facebook. Copy this particular IP. So type this in Firefox. Then open this. So your Facebook will be open. You can also open by the name. You can also open by the IP also. Both the same process. So this is the IP. Minimize. So this is the IP. So this is all about how to assign the IP through the DHCP server. So these two concepts will be completed. The first one, how to assign the static IP. Second one, how to assign the IP through the DHCP server. So this is my first command, and this is my second command, and this is your third command. Suppose if we want to assign the IP through the local DHCP server, so we can also use local DHCP server. Okay. So any doubt regarding these two concepts? Then we show the information how to modify a connection if we want to change my existing configuration. So these are regarding the creation, not for the modification. If we want to do the modification part, if we have a connection already that is created, this one, and in this particular connection we want to modify this, we can't use the DHCP IP through the DHCP. We want to assign the IP that is manual. So how we can assign, how we can change this, that I will discuss in the next session regarding the modification. Regarding the creation concept will be completed. It can be your static and it can be your dynamic. It means what we have completed in my according to my book, I will show you which part I have completed. This one, see here. So how to create the connection through the NMCLI command? This is for the graphical. So which part will be completed? See here. So this is your NMCLI device status to check the status also. And this is for the active connection. I will show this. I have completed only this particular part, how to add a network connection. So which one is the command that can be used? According to book, this is the command. So NMCLI CON. CON means connection. So in a book, there is a short format also available. Add CON name, it's ENO2, type Ethernet, interface name, that is ENO2 also. So in when we give this particular information, this will place in this particular file. This is the file. So everything is placed in a file in Linux. So we can also provide the IP through the file also, and we can also provide the IP through the command also. So there are two concepts. We can also use command and we can also use this. There is another method, that this is IP4. This is also the command. So give the interface name, then type backslash also here. So give your IP also, gateway, that start from GW4. So this is your gateway IP. This is the another method to assign the IP and gateway. I will show this in the next session also. And this one for the IP version 6. This is for the to up the connection, how to down the connection, how to disconnect the connection. These all things I will discuss in the next session. So some of the parts I have completed from this, and how to delete the connection, how to modify the connection through the configuration file. I will discuss this also. These are the concept regarding the file and modification the connection. Then the last portion, that is regarding to the name resolution, that whole portion I will discuss. So this will complete. Okay, so I will start your next session on Tuesday. It's 8/12/2020. Then I will end the session.
Kindly share the recording, sir.
Can we repeat what you are saying?
Share the record to that, ma'am, sir. I will get.
Okay. I will send this particular recording to ma'am. Then you can contact to ma'am. Then this recording will be provided to you.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Then any other?
Excuse me, sir.
Sir wanted to ask. Okay, you can call me Siddhant after the class.
Nahi sir, like just one thing only.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I will end the session. Stop recording.